PT's got a video here to measure an angle to a curve, which is ridiculous. We said you can't measure an angle to a curve.
There are two different lines. One is curved, the second is straight line.
We know you cannot have an angle to a curve.
In this video, I'll be attempting to calculate the acute angle that's between the curve y equals x squared and the line y equals x. And if you're finding it hard to visualize, you could think of it as the maximum angle made by moving this segment as close as possible to the curve without intersecting it anywhere else.
Wow. Nice.
If we want to find the gradient of the secant, then we can use rise over run to work it out. The run is this distance h at the bottom between points x and x plus h, whereas the rise is this distance between the points f of x and f of x plus h, which means we can rewrite rise over run as so. But in order to find this angle, we'll first need to find the slope of the curve at point A. Currently, the secant has a slope of 1.85, but watch what happens when we drag these points closer to point A.
Just wow.
And we ended up with a tangent. To find the slope of this or any tangent on this curve, we can differentiate using first principles. So at this point, we'd like to know what the limit of our gradient function is when the run h approaches zero.
It's shocking.
And that might not make much sense at the moment, because if you plug in zero for h, surely we'll be dividing by zero.
What's he talking about? At a limit where there is no rise. It's ridiculous.
If they want to measure a zero, so okay.
Weird.
Weird, yes.
Well, let's work it through anyway and see what happens. So replacing the x with these values gives us this. We can expand that to this. The x squareds can go, which leaves us with this. The h's cancel. And now plugging in zero for h is no longer a problem. What we're left with is a function that allows us to find the slope of the curve at any point. So for any x-coordinate input, one in the case of point A, we'll get an output for our gradient twice that of our input, two in this case.
Imagine that!
To calculate the angle then, we'll use this formula, where m1 is the slope for the blue line, and m2 is the slope of the curve at point A. Plugging those values in, we can see that our calculation matches the angle measured by the software.
What's that got to do with it?
Oh my goodness.
Okay. That's about it.
PT did a great job. Great job. Thank you.
Mm-hmm.
Thank you very much.
PT, well done. Well done. Good job. What's he talking about?